One.
Hi, LifePoint peeps. I'm Christy Beyer, and I will be your coach today. And this is Kimberly. She will be our example for a little higher intensity, and Sarah will be a little bit on the lower intensity side. So what we are going to do today is a little bit different than what we've done so far. We are going to work with movement preparation, or for a lot of you, that's called warm-up. And what is a warm-up? We want to kind of distinguish. Movement preparation is just trying to get through those body parts that need to be working, that need more blood flow, that need more oxygen, so that you can perform your exercises more efficiently and to their full capacity. So I'm going to give you two different styles today. One is going to be more of area-specific type of warm-up. And the other one's going to be more big body or a general format, so you're using all of your body at the same time for the warm-up. So we're going to go through two of those, and then you get a bonus item today. Our bonus item is going to be some exercises, muscle exercises, non-weight oriented, that will help you get rid of that little desk neck that you have nowadays. You know, from looking at your text or looking at your computer, especially when you've been stuck at home all this time, and probably that computer is being more and more utilized. So we're going to try to get rid of that desk neck. So, are you guys ready?
Absolutely.
All right. So Sarah's going to be sitting, and we're going to start with area-specific movements. So we're going to start from the top and work our way all the way to the bottom. I like people to stand if they can, but if you need to sit, by all means, sit when you need to sit and stand when you need to stand. I'm going to start with our neck. We're going to start with bringing your chin into your chest and then dropping your head back. You will start noticing some of these exercises we've done in other videos. Some of them we haven't, so some of them are new. We're going to go through each item three different times, maybe even five, getting through that full extension. Now we're going to go through a rotation. We're going to do two exercises with each part of the body. So you're going to slide your chin over a tabletop, keeping those shoulders low, going from side to side. And we're going to do one more on each side, and then we're going to warm up our shoulders. With our shoulders, we're going to start with a shoulder roll, coming forward, nice and around. And again, your muscles are kind of chilly, so we want to warm them up slow and dynamically. And we're going to rotate them backwards, lifting those shoulders up, making that circle smooth and controlled, opening up the chest, squeezing those shoulder blades. Now we're going to move to a round circle, reaching the arms up. Keep that focus in the front and then push a bubble down towards your feet. You're going to inhale on the way up and exhale as you push a floating bubble. Feeling that resistance on the way up and feeling that gentle resistance on the way down. Inhale up and around. Exhale as you come. We're going to move into the spine. You're going to push one hand up to the ceiling, one hand down to the floor, trying to open up the length of your spine. And then you're going to switch hands. Turn the other hand up, push that ceiling off your head, and push the floor away from your feet. We're trying to create space within the discs of your spine. Trying to open up the vertebrae, long through the spine, almost as if you're pulling taffy. You've got a big piece of taffy and you're trying to pull it away from each other. We're going to inhale up and exhale down. Inhale up and exhale down. We're going to move to a rotation. We did this one the other day as we're turning to one side. Bring one hand behind you, and one hand, wrap it around your waist. Slow and controlled, looking over your spine, trying to look over that shoulder as if a car is trying to pass you. gentle and easy. You may even want to hold it there just for 1 second as you grab and open that back shoulder. Try to push that back shoulder, just open up just a little further. One more time, last one. And we're going to move into our hips with a hip extension and a hip flexion. So if you need stability for a chair, you can hold on to a chair to the side. We're going to extend that hip back, touch that toe behind you, counterbalance with your hands, and then you're going to touch that heel forward in front of you. If you're not needing that balance, both hands will come up in front. Push that air behind you as that heel comes forward. You're going to inhale as you lift and exhale as you set down. We're trying to open up that hip joint, trying to mobilize it forward and backward. One more time to the back, and then one more time to the front. If you're using a supportive device, then you want to switch sides. Sarah's going to move to the other side as well. So we are going to take it back first, and then we're going to bring it forward. Same thing, full extension. As you're reaching back behind, make sure you keep that rib cage down and toward your hips so you help protect that low back. Trying not to arch that back, but get a full extension. One more time to the back, and one more time to the front. Now we're gonna move into a knee extension. So that knee extension, that's gonna create another opportunity to increase your balance. So if you need something to hold on to, great. If you don't, we're going to start with a knee extension. You're going to bring that knee up and extend it out and then bend it back again, pointing through the toe, lengthening the legs. If it's too hard for that knee to be up, you can come down and you can touch your toe to the floor and then bring it in, and then touch your toe to the floor. To do the same thing on the other side with that knee extension. So you're going to bring that knee up and you're going to extend and then let it relax. The quadricep starting to work and be engaged a little bit. So we're getting some blood flow and some oxygen into the quadriceps through the knee. Good. Let's move over to the other side again. We're going to warm up the back of the leg. We just did the front of the leg, now we're going to do the back of the leg. So we want to work that hamstring, trying to touch that heel. If you need that chair, great. If you don't need to, you can push both hands back and try to reach that heel. And as Sarah's showing you, some things just don't work as good on the chair. So if you can stand and open up as best you can, that's awesome. All right, let's switch to the other side. Back of your leg, your hamstring is being engaged, trying to get some blood flow back there as well. This is a good one, especially if you've been sitting a lot, to try to open up that hip and get that extension toward the back. Awesome. And then the last part, as we're moving down to our ankles now, we're going to do a pronation and supination. So hands can be on your hips, they can be on your chair if you need it, or you can trip on a chair if you need to as well. Just don't fall. But we're going to do little toe to the ground, and then try to put your big toe in about the same spot if you can. So you're going to go little toe to big toe. We also get a little bit of hip opener as well with that. But we're trying to work mostly with that ankle in the pronation and supination. And let's go to the other side. Kimberly, how are you doing?
Doing well.
Is the balance going well for you?
Mostly.
All right. So we're going to go big toe to little toe again. You can always use the wall too if you need to.
That's a good idea.
For that balance. Your balance usually comes right right from underneath that belly. So you want to hold in strong, get that spine up nice and tall. Now we're going to do a flexion and extension. We're going to first point that toe. You're going to point the toe, lift up that knee, and put that heel in that same spot. The further that foot is away from the body, the harder that is going to be to balance. So if you want to bring it right into the center, that's going to be a little bit easier. If you try to push it out to the front, that's going to be a little bit harder. But that also challenges that balance. Good job. Let's switch feet. Last one on this side. We're going to start with that point and then the flex. So you're pretending you're driving a car and you're pushing down that pedal, but then you got to slam on the brakes with your heel. Slam on that brake and gun it. And step side by side. So that is our single joint area type of warm-up. And you can use that along with some of our other as preparatory stuff if you want to use that. Some people, that's just what they want to wake up with in the morning, is get every part of their body moving in some way, shape, or form. So it's not long, it's just a short scenario, and just start from one end and go to the next. The next set of exercises is going to be our full body dynamic movement. It's going to be a little more aggressive. You might feel your body get a little bit warmer through this. Good preparatory movements for before you start your strength training. So you could maybe add this before Sarah or Kimberly need their next strength training activities. I know they always do warm-ups anyway, but you can be double warm if you need to. All right. So the next one, we're going to start with a low knee march. We're going to start with a low knee march, and you're going to try to tap your knees from side to side. As you get a little bit more warm, we're going to get further extension. If you can get further extension, work in those oppositions. And if you can see Kimberly in the back, she's getting a lot of movement and rotation with the waist as well. We're going to do each of these movements for 30 seconds. So we're just going to keep moving. You can go fast, you can go slow, but you still remember this is prep work. All right, we're going to stop with that one. We're going to go to our rotational step. So you're going to do a big L step out to the side. At the same time, your hands are going to be up and your hands going to follow back to the back. And then bring the feet parallel to each other, and we're going to alternate from side to side. So you're going to pretend you have a golden egg in your hand, and you do not want to lose that golden egg. We get a little opener of the hips. We get some chest openers. If this starts to hurt your shoulders, you can draw those elbows in and just do it smaller motions to the side. Because I know sometimes as you're holding those elbows or shoulders, it gets a little difficult if you've had any injuries. But we're opening up the hips, opening up the shoulders. Now we're going to do a butt kick. With our butt kick, we're going to reach that heel back, push it back to your heels. And again, you can do low, slow, just trying to touch your heels to the back, trying to retract those shoulder blades each time you come back without popping up that rib cage. We want to keep that rib cage down, pulled in and back. As you're touching, anytime you're going back behind you, you want to make sure you got that good, strong, tall posture. All right, we're going to go to the front again, and we're going to work with our soldier walks. Soldier walk is a straight leg, just like your nutcracker. Remember the nutcracker, long legs, strong legs, straight legs. The lower you go, the easier it gets. The higher you go, the harder it gets. So you choose what works best for you. We got all kinds of options for you. Low, medium, and high. So pick what works best for you. Has that been 30 seconds yet? I haven't been paying attention.
I'm not sure.
All right. Now we're going to move into a diagonal reach. Or if you're a yoga person, it's a star pose. So we're going to going to start with pointing the toe out to the side, raise the opposite arm, trying to work from the back of your hand, pushing backwards. And again, don't pop open that rib cage. Keep it nice and supported. And then you're going to step in and change sides. So we're opening, low level is on that chair, but see how Sarah is still opening up her hips, really working strong through those hips and opening his back, trying to take that hand back as far as she can. And now Kimberly's going to a higher level, and she's taking it into more of a balanced pose, working through that leg and lifting, squeezing those glutes in order to do that, but still lengthening that space between her fingertips and her toes. All right, let's bring it back to the middle. We're gonna do a mini squat. We're also gonna add an external rotation, or what I like to call an L rotation. So we're gonna do a mini squat. So sit down into your heels, reach out, pull your elbows back, your shoulder blades back, palms go up, thumbs turn back toward that back wall. And then we squat again, reach out, pull in, back and down, keeping those shoulders low and level. Reach, pull, rotate. Reach, pull, and rotate. Trying to make each of these movements as smooth as you can and as controlled as you can, and pay attention to the muscles that you're trying to warm up. We got some quadriceps, some glutes, upper back rhomboid area. Got a big deltoid move right here. All right. Here's going to be another big move. We're going to start in a W. So see how my hands are down, middle, down, and up. We're starting in a W, and we're going to go into a Spider-Man. Sometimes you can do these on floor. Sometimes you can do them in standing position. I'm not going to take anybody to the floor unless you want to go to the floor. But we're going to take an elbow to a knee, or as close to it as you can. So even if you can't get your knees up, we're trying to get a waist bend in there. We're trying to get that knee as close to the elbow as you possibly can. If you really want to intensify this movement, take one hand and reach it up toward the sky. Trying to get up that wall. Where does Spider-Man live?
Okay. New York.
In New York? Okay, so one of those skyscrapers in New York. Try to grab up that skyscraper. Again, working through those hips, that external rotation through those hips, little waist action, and also make sure you're pulling those shoulders back and don't let it round, which is very common. All right, we just got a couple more left. The next ones are gonna be more of a standing position. We can do one seated, one standing. This takes a little balance, so you may need that chair again. It is a leg cradle. So we're going to start with just trying to touch your heel and crossing your leg. Sometimes I call this a number four stretch. So on one side, you can see how that action looks like a four. I don't know if that was the right way for you or not, but but to make it a cradle, if you have the flexibility to do so, then you can bring that leg up, pull it up higher for a bigger stretch, down, up, and pull it up. Like I said, I can't do this a lot, especially when I'm in rocker shoes today. You can add that little extra pull if you need that extra pull to really give some flexibility into those hips. All right, our last move for this one is going to be a step back lunge with a bicep curl. That chair, go ahead and grab it. But we're going to step back, push that heel back as the biceps come, your hands come to your shoulders. Step back, heel down to the floor, long straight leg and back, sitting back so that front knee slightly bends. You want to make sure we're not jetting that toe over the knee over the toe. We're sitting back into it so that knee stays right over the ankle. So if you need to take a shorter step for that to happen, do what you need to do to make that effective. All right. Are you Well, that is our second type of warm-up. That is more dynamic, full body, general, overall, not specific. Like the first group was specific, this one was more general. And the next one I want to do is I'm gonna work on that bonus item I told you we were gonna work on, and that is to try to get rid of that desk neck. Try to make those muscles strong. A lot of things that we do nowadays are forward flexion on the computers, we're reading books, we're reading our texts, you know, with our phones. A lot of things are trying to get that neck. So we need to strengthen the muscles in the back of the neck, the upper back, in order to work on that. So I got three simple moves you can do almost anywhere. Some of them you can even do in your car while you're stopped at a stoplight. Don't do it while you're driving, but when you're stopped at a stoplight, you can definitely throw some of these in. The first one is gonna be a chin tuck. So what I want you to do is think about that chin. It's on a tabletop, and you're gonna try to pull that chin back as if you're trying to push your head on the wall behind you. Okay? This one sometimes is a little hard for people as we go through that range of motion, because people want to go back and forth, up and down. Okay? We want to really pull it back. So sometimes it's helpful to have two fingers on your chin and try to push that chin straight back. Push that chin straight back. Another option for this, if you have a wall available to you, you can take that wall, put the shoulder back, and try to push your head next to the wall. So try to push that head right next to that wall. So you gotta, any way you're doing it, you're trying to get that double, triple chin in there. It's the only time you want that double chin, but this is one that we get. So that is exercise number one. You can do it in two different ways. You can either do it in repetitions, doing about 10 to 15 repetitions, or you can do a hold. If you take it back and hold for about 3 to 5 seconds and then relax, that's an option as well. If you do that, only do about 5 of those. Otherwise, you're gonna get two tense probably through there. The next move, we kind of did this already in our warm-up. We did our W's. So, ladies, let's get back into that W. So fingers are about ear height, elbows are down, and then you have a couple different ways we can do this. As you can see, Kimberly, she's up against that wall. If you're up against the wall, you wanna make sure that that tailbone is tucked. Even if you're sitting in a chair, you wanna tuck that tailbone, drop that rib cage down, and then try to put the back of your hands on that wall. As you do that, you're gonna pull those elbows down into your hips, trying to keep that W, and then go back up. So you're gonna exhale down and hold for 3, 2, 1, and relax. The other thing that you're doing is you're going through that range of motion. We're not moving from the neck and the shoulders, but we're trying to use the muscles right in the middle of the back, trying to take the shoulder blades down into the back pelvis, right through the middle of your pant seam. So come down and hold for 3, 2, 1, and relax. Okay, shake those out.
Ooh, that was hard.
That was some muscle work, wasn't it? All right, we're gonna add those to some other letters. We'll come back to that W, you'll see it in a little bit, but we're gonna go into a Y. Remember, was it Village People that did YMCA? So y'all know how to do a Y, correct? So, arms are long, arms are strong, and we're gonna point those thumbs so they're going back to that back wall. And similar situation, you don't want those shoulders to guide up into your ears. We wanna keep those shoulders down and extend through those lats. And then we're gonna try to push those thumbs back to that back wall. And forward, back to that back wall. And I don't know if you noticed it or not, but I didn't do it very well. As I was pushing back, I opened up that rib cage and my butt started sticking back. So we want that rib cage down, tailbone tucked under, keep that spine nice and long, and you're trying to open up into that Y. Exhale as you go back, inhale as you come forward. All right. Now let's go back to that W. We won't hold it this time. We're gonna make it more dynamic and we're just gonna go right through it again. So we're gonna start from that Y and then come down into into that Y, down into the W. The wall is a fun place to be, right? So if you can't see it from the side view, but her shoulders are doing really good. If you had me on this wall, my shoulders would be clear out here. She's got some good posture going on there. Her rib cage is staying down low. Her hips are tilted slightly. So you're trying to get almost a slight back. Sarah's doing an awesome job. Okay, enough of those. Relax those shoulders. Ooh. Shake them out.
Man, nice.
See, you don't need any hand weights, right?
Oh, yeah.
All right, and then the next letter, so we got Y's, W's, and we have L's. We did this one in our warm-up too, as we did our squats. So your elbows are nice and close to your sides, palms are facing up, and you're gonna rotate those thumbs back as far as you can and hold. You're trying to get that arm parallel, so fingertips and elbows are parallel. So try to bring those hands just down just a little bit, right there. Ooh, yeah. But only do it where you feel like you can. If it's causing pain, don't go into the painful situation. Always go where you can, but try your best. Even if you can't get into that parallel to the floor position, then you want to imagine it in your brain, because sometimes our brains can help us get into those positions. Holding that heavy plate back, and you can do repetitions, or you can do isometric holds of 5 seconds. And then we got I, W, then T is our last one. So T we can do a couple different ways. So we got our Y's into our W's, into our L's, and now we're gonna open up into a T. So you're still holding those platters, trying to get those shoulders back on that back wall, trying to pelvic tilt, trying to, the thing about this is some people like me, I'm so tight in those shoulders come up. So if your shoulders start to come up on you, bring those hands down to a level where you can hold it out long, and try to push back into that wall. And that's even harder when you're trying not to open up that rib cage or those hips. You wanna try to keep that nice and held stable. And try to go back. So you can do 3 different ways with those T's. You can go thumbs back, you can go thumbs up, and you can go pinkies back. All of which can be very beneficial, but you're gonna feel different muscles working through each of those positions. So that is your bonus for today, is doing that upper back, trying to get rid of that neck, that computer neck, desk neck. So have a good day, and we'll